So let me introduce myself. I got very big name, but you can call me with my short name, Sai. And I got over more than 15 years of experience on Oracle applications. I worked in India. Most of my experience is in India. Apart from India, I worked in UK, Abu Dhabi, Damascus, that is Syria, Dubai, and Thailand also. I worked more than 2 years in Thailand on Oracle applications. So currently I am working with a company called as Abstract Solutions Private Limited, and also I am doing training here. Because training is my passion, I started my career as a trainer. So I love training, so that is the reason I am also doing part-time training at Durgasoft. Durgasoft is going to be one of the branded company for training. We have students across the globe, and most of the students we have from India. And next count, I can say that USA, we have a lot of students, and we also have students from UK, Australia, New Zealand, and Gulf also, that is Dubai. Lot of students. Our main courses that we run at Durga is Java, Core Java, other softwares, and being I am one of the senior faculty for Oracle application, we also introduced Oracle application at Durgasoft. So in the introduction class we are going to learn why Oracle applications that we require to do. We have too many ERPs available. We have ERP like SAP, ERPs like PeopleSoft, Bon, JD Edwards, Microsoft Dynamics. We have too many ERPs available. But keeping all this aside, why you require to do Oracle applications? What is there in the Oracle application? Why I should choose only Oracle application? Why not SAP? Why not PeopleSoft? All that we'll try to understand in my introduction class. But before that, there is a few students, they used to ask me, what is the difference between Oracle and Oracle applications? So before we proceed and understand Oracle and Oracle applications, let me tell you some simple examples which will be comfortable for you, which you can able to understand. Then slowly we'll go into Oracle applications. So don't expect that you want to learn whole Oracle application in one day or 1 week or 1 month, and immediately next month you want to do Oracle job. It is not possible. So you need to learn with love and affection and with a passion. So that way I am going to help you in learning Oracle application. Now let me just help you out. What do you mean by Oracle and difference between Oracle and Oracle application? Both will try to understand. Now here you see, you know that Oracle Corporation. What is Oracle Corporation? It's the name of the company. Oracle Corporation is what? Basically name of the company. Now Oracle application, mainly we have two different softwares. One is Oracle applications. Oracle Corporation is the name of the company, and Oracle is one software that we have. Other than Oracle, we also have Oracle applications. So let us understand the difference between Oracle and Oracle applications. Now Oracle, what do you call Oracle? I call too many words, but you understand whichever is comfortable for you. Oracle I call RDBMS. Oracle I call backend. Oracle we can call it as database. What do you get in Oracle? In Oracle you get SQL and PLSQL. SQL, PLSQL together you call Oracle. And the latest version going in Oracle is what? Not 11G. After 11G we also have one more, that is called as 12C also we have. We also have 12C, but prior to 12C we have 11G, before 11G we got 10G, before that 9i, before that 8i, like that we have too many versions, but latest version going in Oracle is 12C. Now coming to Oracle applications, Oracle applications is called as what? ERP package you also call e-business suite. So I call e-business suite, you call ERP package, that's up to you. What you want to call, how you want to call, that matters. Whatever you are understanding, whichever you understand comfortably, you take it that. But Oracle is database, backend, SQL, you get in Oracle. Whereas Oracle application, ERP package, you also call it as e-business suite. Now coming to Oracle application, the latest version is what? R12. Before R12, 11i. Before that 11.0. Before that 10.7 we have. Even before that we also have 10.6. Now quite often students, they used to get confused. What kind of confusion? What is the difference between, here you see, here also we have 11, here also we have 11, here also you can see 11.0. so don't get confused. When I say 11G, 11G is a version which belongs to Oracle. Coming to 11.0, this is a version belongs to Oracle applications. And again we have 11i. 11i is also part of Oracle applications. So don't get confused, please. I am repeating again. 11G, Oracle. Here 11.0 or 11i is part of Oracle application. Now let us understand the major, let me give simple example, then based on your understanding of this example we'll go further. So let me make you very clear what is the difference between Oracle and Oracle applications. Now I went to forest. What do you are going to do in the forest? Probably for hunting, probably for joying, for a small joy trip, you may go for forest. You went to forest with your friends, maybe relation, maybe neighbor. The program was being scheduled for 3 days. You went to forest, 3 days you enjoy, third day all you people coming back to your hometown, maybe your town or your city. Third day what happened? You misplaced. You got diverted. And what happened? You got diverted and you could not able to reach the home that night. Then you slept over in the forest. Next to 2 days you are there in the forest. Only in the third day evening you could able to identify the route map or the map to come back to your home. So third day you reach your home. You are feeling so hungry. Dead hungry. You feel like eating whatever is come in front of you. Food, fruits, anything, bread, butter, jam, anything. So finally what do? You go to your room and you take bath. You never take any bath. Forget about your bath, changing the clothes, nothing that you do. What do? You directly run to your kitchen. Where you go? Run to the kitchen. Kitchen, what you do? Whatever is there in the kitchen or whatever is there in your dining table, you right away go and eat that because you are feeling so hungry. You eat that, or what do? You go to kitchen and cut the knife, take the knife and cut your stomach and put the food directly into your stomach. You are feeling so hungry, right? So when you feel hungry, what do? You cut the stomach and put the directly food. You never do that activity. There is a full job. You are so hungry also, you are so hungry also, you never cut your stomach. Rather, what you do, eat the food very fast, very quickly, because you want to make your stomach, your body, yourself so happy. So that is the reason you never cut your stomach. Take the food quickly and feel that your stomach should be comfortable, you are comfortable, your body should be comfortable. That's how you do. Similarly, here also, gentlemen, let me make you understand how oracle and oracle application get differed. So in oracle, what will be there? I am saying that oracle is a database. I am saying that oracle is a back end. Oracle application is what? It's an ERP. What is there in the ERP? ERP consists of modules. What is that? ERP consists of modules, mind you. So what kind of modules that you have? I am just giving some example, please. This is only example. Tomorrow, don't come back and say that Oracle consists of only these four. No. Oracle got too many modules. I can't put all the modules on the screen. For a glance, for example, I am just taking these four modules. Oracle application, example, consists of modules like purchasing, payable, order management, receivables, so on. So these are the modules that we have, for example. Now, in the modules, what we do? These modules, we process our business data. What do you mean by processing our business data? Let's say, example, my company, my organization adopted the ERP, purchased the ERP. Which ERP? Any ERP. Let us talk about our ERP, Oracle applications. My company purchased Oracle application ERP. So my company, what we do? What is our business process? Our business process is basically buy, sell, buy, pay, sell, receive. This is what our activity. So as of now, let us limit our discussion. Purchase, pay, sell, receive. This is what we are going to do as of now. Now, when you talk about these modules, four modules, and these modules are what? These modules are part of, not something else. Yes, it is modules of, these modules are part of our ERP called as what? Our ERP called as Oracle application. In Oracle applications, you get all this. What you get all this? These are the modules you get. Oracle application ERP package consists of these modules. In these modules, what we do? We process our information. What kind of information? Today I purchase material in the morning. Where you record? You go to module called as purchasing module and you record that we purchase material. In the evening, what we did? Evening we are going to pay to our vendor, our supplier we pay. So where you record? You pay him and you come back to your system and you record in payables that payment being paid to so and so vendor, Amazon vendor, Snapdeal vendor, Flipkart vendor, some vendor, Walmart vendor. We are not worried about who is a vendor. So we purchase, we record in purchasing module. We pay, we record in payable module. Then the material is with us now, the item is with us now. The item is lying, it is available with us. What do you do with the item? We sell the item. To whom you sell? I am going to sell to my customer. Who is my customer? Someone. Let us not worry about his name. Let us not worry about his address as of now. Some address should be there. Without address, how can you sell? So what is the name of the customer? Some damn dicky. Let us not worry about what is his full details as of now. We are going to identify some customer. We are going to sell the material to our customer. So here you see, whenever I want to sell the product, where I record? I record in order management. order management, what we do, we record all sales activity. What activity? Sales activity. So we book the sales activity in order management, then accordingly we supply the material to our customer. We sell, we bill. Whom we sell? Our customer. Whom we bill? Our customer. We sell, we bill. So here in order management, what we do? We sell the receivables. What we do? We bill our customer. The moment we bill the customer, what would happen? One day we are going to get the funds from our customer. Other day we made a payment to our vendor, our supplier we made. Today who will pay? Your customer will pay. When your customer will pay, for him it is a payment, but for me it is not payment. For me it is a receipt. I am going to receive. From where I am going to receive? I receive through receivable module. Where I receive? From receivable module. And what is all this? All these are called as modules, and all these modules are part of Oracle application ERP. So ERP consists of what? Modules. What do you do in the modules? You process your data. You purchase, you record. You pay, you record. So all this activity, where it will go and store, you know, finally? This activity, whatever you are recording, finally it will go and store where? It will go and store in a database. Earlier I told you one simple example, that forest example. You are feeling so hungry. What do? You cut your stomach and put the food directly into your stomach? Never you do that. When you are feeling hungry, what do? You take your bread, butter, jam, or food, whatever you want to take, you take through your mouth. So here also, you record data where? You record the data in the modules. And all these modules are what? All these are modules are part of what? Oracle application. Oracle application, you record the data. This data finally, where will come? This data finally go and store in Oracle database. Now let us proceed further and understand some more interesting concepts about Oracle applications. You might be knowing what is Java. And Durgasoft is prone for Java. I'm just asking you guys, you know the meaning for Java? Forget about meaning, you know what is Java? Java is what? Is a game? Or name of the person? Or name of the country? No. No, it is not that. What is Java? Java is a programming language. Like what? C is what? C is a programming language. C++ is a programming. COBOL is also programming. Similarly, Java is also programming language. You know what do you mean by Java? We decided there is nothing further to decide about Java. It's not a game. It's a programming language. Now, what do you mean by Java? I'm trying to ask you. The meaning of Java is what? Coffee beans. What do you call? Coffee beans. Seeds. Brownish, blackish color seeds is there, right? That is, those are called as Java beans. I don't know how many people would have opened the Java books, textbooks. The Java textbook, you can see cup and saucer. Within that cup you can see coffee, and that you can see streams. So cup of coffee, and the streams, you can see further Java. Now the meaning of Java is what? Coffee seeds or coffee beans. Keeping that aside, one more meaning we have for Java. What is that meaning? There is a island. What? There is an island called as Java Island. Where? Not in India. There is a, in the Indonesia, we have an island called as Java Island. So the meaning of Java is what? Coffee beans, coffee seeds. One more meaning is what? Island called as Java. So don't open any Google now. You go to your home. From the home, you can search what is the meaning for Java. Now let us not worry about Java. Let us get into Oracle. Being we are learning Oracle applications, being we are learning Oracle related software, let us understand the meaning for Oracle. Anyone knows about Oracle? Oracle is what? Game? No. Oracle, you know that it is a software. Even I know that it is a software. Everyone knows that it is a software. But I am not asking it is a software, I am asking you the meaning for Oracle. What do you mean by Oracle? Now, I am not asking you who is the person behind Oracle. I am asking you what do you mean by Oracle. So let me show you on the screen what do you mean by Oracle. So meaning for Oracle is what? Meaning for Oracle is voice of the God. In your local language, what do you call? Devuni Vaku. In Hindi, what do you call? Khuda ka awaz, Bhagwan ka awaz. So-called English, what we call? So-called English, we call it as voice of the God. Now, one dictionary is saying very clearly voice of the God. We have too many dictionaries. Oxford, Longman, we have too many dictionaries. What about other dictionary is saying? Other dictionary is saying voice without physical appearance. Voice is coming out, but no presence of the body. So that can be voice of the God, even that can be voice of the devil also. Because devil you can't see sometimes, God also you can't see sometimes. But let us not be in a negative sense, let us be in a very very positive sense. Let us conclude it. Oracle is nothing but voice of the God. Now, before I go for next slide, I will ask you few things. Now tell me, most of the people sitting here knows about Microsoft. Who is the key person behind Microsoft? The key person behind Microsoft, anyone? Yes, the key person behind Microsoft is Bill Gates' uncle. Who is that? Bill Gates. Not Bill Clinton. Bill Clinton was president. So I'm talking about what? Bill Gates. So Bill Gates is a key person behind Microsoft. Now tell me, who is a key person behind Oracle? Oh, it's not me. I am not the key person behind Oracle. If I am a key person behind Oracle, I would have not given the lecture. I would be sitting somewhere else. So I am not the key person. There is a couple of key persons behind Oracle. Who is the key person behind Oracle? We'll understand. So there is a basically three people behind Oracle Corporation. The company, today you are calling it as Oracle Corporation, but when the company was started initially, it was not Oracle Corporation, it was something else. What was that? I will explain you later. Now here you see there is a three people behind Oracle. Number one, Larry Ellison. Number two, Bob Minner. Number three, Edwards. So these are the three people behind Oracle who started the company long back. I can say before your birth. Before your birth, he would have started the company. But by the time I born, So these three people behind Oracle, the current chairman of the company is Mr. Larry Ellison, but being his aged person, he given to some other people who is working under him. So is today also is a main guy behind Oracle, but he is not main CEO, he is a chairman of the company. There is some other CEO with name Paul, some other lady who is currently ruling the company. Now let me go back to the history of the company. Let me tell you the history of the company. Let us understand the history of the company. I request everyone to read this, please. Just read what is there in the screen. Read by yourself. Try to understand. It is simple English. Make it fast. Don't read loudly. Read by yourself. Done. Read the second paragraph. Yes, let's proceed. Now three people started a company. What is the name of the company? RSI. What is that? RSI. What do you mean by that? Relational Software Incorporated. Today the name of the company is what? Today the name of the company is Oracle Corporation. But initially when it started, that is the name RSI. Now what was the goal? What was the target? The target, the goal was not Oracle application, not the ERP. ERP has come later. First, initially their target, their goal was what? Their target, their goal initially was all about database, Oracle, just database, that's it. So goal to develop RDBMS. What do you mean by RDBMS? RDBMS is nothing but collection of all related data. What do you mean by related data? Collection of employee information, collection of student information, student name, student ID, student blood group, student classroom, student height, weight, all that related to student. Similarly, employee information, you gather all employee information. So what RDBMS can generally we do? In RDBMS, we collect all related data. We gather all related data. So when company was started, their focus was only on RDBMS, database. Only database, RDBMS initially. So the name was what? RSI. The target goal was what? Goal was to develop RDBMS. So what is the name of the RDBMS name they gave? The name of the RDBMS they gave is Oracle. So they want to develop RDBMS, and RDBMS name they chosen is what? They chosen something called as Oracle. To develop Oracle, what they took help? What was the software they took the help to develop Oracle? C and SQL language. So C and SQL language is the two softwares, two languages. Using this, Oracle was developed. What is Oracle? Oracle is a database, RDBMS. Now forget about this. We'll see something. I'll ask you something, then we'll come back to this quickly. You people know, you people heard about DOS? DOS, MS-DOS. What is DOS? Disk operating system. How DOS was developed? Any idea, anyone sitting here? Last you? Yes. Yes. DOS is a disk operating system. To develop the DOS, it's not Delphi. It's not Visual Basic. It's not Unix. Yes. No, it's not that. We have a software called as assembler language, not assembly, it is assembler. There is a language called as assembler language, binary language. Using assembler language, DOS was being developed. Similarly, tomorrow someone would ask you, how Oracle was developed? Oracle was being developed with the help of C and SQL language. Which language? Using C and SQL language, Oracle was being developed. So make it very clear, Oracle developed using C and SQL language.